Let's talk about Katie Joy without a crystal ball and the I Stand with Sophie drama. This is nothing new for Katie Joy. Let's just put it out there. She's got a long history, in my opinion, of exploiting minor children for money. It's really upsetting to me. I've watched her do this for months. I don't care when she wants to talk about adult celebrities. They put themselves out there. They're public figures. So I figure, you know, that's fine. But when you go after minor children, they don't have a say in this. Most of these kids did not ask to be public figures, didn't ask to have their life plastered all over social media. So to me, it's a line that shouldn't be crossed. But obviously, it's a line that Katie Joy easily crosses. In regards to the Sophie, I Stand with Sophie, she had posted on their Facebook page that she has this huge following on YouTube and she wanted them to send her videos and audios so she could put them on her channel, trying to act like she's a friend of this group. And unfortunately for them, at first they believed her, and I think they sent her quite a few files. But in true Katie Joy fashion, she was not about spreading the word, because that's never what she does. Because let's just be clear, it's always about Katie Joy first and foremost. So unfortunately, this group kind of fell for it and sent her stuff. And of course, she hurried up, made a video and loaded it, trying to make her money. And by the way, I have no problem with people making money. I just don't want them to make it exploiting minors. There's the difference. So after she uploaded one or two videos, she then did a live. Well, her live was much different, and they always are. And in her live, she says that she accuses Sophie of acting bratty, and maybe she's not telling the truth, and maybe her dad is just doing this GoFundMe to make money off his child, which is pretty disgusting. So I think what happened was then the Facebook group, somebody told them what she was doing and sent them that live video. And they were not happy, let me tell you. So then they started, a lot of people started the backlash on Twitter, replying to her tweets, telling her to stop and not to exploit Sophie, and that Sophie wasn't a liar and she's not a brat. So, of course, Katie Joy hurried and deleted most of them. I've seen them, but I didn't want to post them here because they weren't my screenshots. But there was a lot of people really upset with her over this. So, of course, Katie Joy turns it around, makes herself the victim, and says that she's not going to make any more videos on this because she got doxxed, her family got doxxed. I have seen no truth to this. I have not seen anywhere where anybody doxxed her or her family. But this is how Katie Joy operates. She'll always turn it around and make herself the victim. She deleted the live video, but, you know, the internet's forever. I know people were reposting it on Twitter, and then her excuse was people are taking it out of context, which was blatantly false because they were showing the whole video. There was nothing taken out of context. You know, Katie Joy's got to stand behind what she says. She said the child was acting bratty. She said she was probably lying. She said her son lies, so this Sophie's probably lying too, which makes no sense. It's just ridiculous. I mean, the only thing I could think of is, you know, maybe her son lied about something silly, like how much ice cream did you eat, which is not the same as lying about somebody abused me. These are two very different things. I'm really glad the Facebook group caught on to what she was doing. And I was told they banned her. But, of course, she had already made, I think she made three videos about Sophie to make sure she could make all her money off this child. Then when people brought up to her that she shouldn't have put, I guess one of her videos had like 9 ads, one of the Sophie videos. So people asked her why she did that. They told her she shouldn't have monetized her videos about Sophie. So her excuse, which is always the same excuse, is if I don't monetize it, YouTube won't show it. That's blatantly false too. My channel is not monetized yet, and yes, I'm trying to get it monetized, but even if it was, I would never do a video about a child and then put ads on it. I would never do that because I have morals, because I'm not all about the money. I mean, you can see here on her Social Blade, these were her highest viewed videos. So Lord only knows how much money she made off of Sophie. It's just disgusting, I think. And as if that wasn't enough, after this big drama, people asking her not to make this money off a child, what does she do? Within a day or so, now she's doing videos on Colin Gosselin. Okay, and once again, this is a child who did not ask to be in the public eye, specifically asked not to be in the public eye because he refused to film anymore with the whole Kate Plus 8 and all that. So obviously this is a kid that doesn't want this. Now, he did post something on, I think, Instagram or something, and then it was deleted right away. But again, this isn't for Katie to make money off of. This is a minor child. Who knows what happened? Maybe got mad as dad posted something, regretted it, took it back down. I don't know. I don't know what happened, but I know he's a teen. Those are some rough years. They're even rougher years when you've grown up the way he has. But again, there's no line Katie won't cross, so of course she hurries up and makes a video about it. And what's really funny to me is she says how she researched it. Now, come on, Katie. You saw the tweet or the post like everybody else did. There was no research done. You just saw a post and made a long video, filled it in with stuff you said in other videos about him. It's ridiculous. I mean, at least be honest and don't say you put all this research into it. She says she messaged John to get his take on it and like they're good friends or something. Come on, Katie, you know that isn't true. I don't think you and John Gosselin are buddies. So probably why he never answered you, right? I mean, it's just, that's her research. She sees a post on the internet, makes a whole video about it, and then claims to have researched it. It's so frustrating to me. I mean, I could go on and on about the things I disagree with Katie Joy. But she has really outdone herself in the last 30 days with all these posts about minor children. I'm never going to agree with that. You know, there's so many stories out there. There's no reason to have to exploit, manipulate, and make money off these minor kids that had no say in any of this. So that's my thoughts for today. Comment down below. Let me know what you think. I hope you guys all have a great night. Thanks.